Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Jimmy Dore Show. I'm here with Ron Placone and Steph Zamorano. And
howdy,
hey,
howdy.
There you go. And we're talking about the Democrats have no message, and it's becoming painfully obvious. So here is what's wrong with the Democrats, right? Here is a perfect example. At the DNC chair, Chris Cuomo asked Peter Pekarsky, who was running for the DNC chair and is a lawyer, to give a straight answer, make the case for the Democrats. And here's his no answer.
What is the case for the Democrats right now?
The case for the Democrats right now is to re-energize the entire Democratic Party.
Okay, so you there's no case. He doesn't. What? Huh? What do we stand for? I can't say what we stand for because that means corporations and big money donors. So I have to think of something else on my feet. I'm a lawyer. You think I could? I can't. That's how devoid of a soul that the Democratic Party is right now. And that's why they lost to Trump and they're wiped out at every level of government. It's that. There's no message. Here's another woman at in San Diego just a few nights ago asking the Democratic congressman, Scott Peters, I think is his name, the same question. Hey, make the case for the Democrats. What do you stand for, she asks. And this is what he says.
I walked precincts for Hillary Clinton and for Barack Obama. When I walked the precincts, I walked the same ones each year. And the people I walked were working people, two and three jobs. Even the ones who said they were voting Democratic couldn't tell me what the Democrats stood for. So I'm here to ask you in front of God and everybody, what the heck does a Democrat stand for?
What do Democrats stand for? Well, standing up for what's right and the notion that everyone gets a chance and everyone gets to be treated fairly. That's one thing. And I think the other side of that is an opportunity. Democrats stand for everyone getting that same opportunity to get the American dream. If they work hard, and they're not making excuses, but everyone deserves that opportunity.
So they have nothing but empty platitudes. And this is what happens when a party's been hollowed out by corporate money. They're hollow. They have nothing. They have no mess. What's our plan? I don't know. Barack Obama's nice. That's our plan. Barack Obama, people like him. But what's your plan to help people? We're supposed to help people? I thought we're just supposed to not be assholes like Donald Trump and then they'll elect us. No, we tried that last time. You guys are wiped out. Do you see this? Do you see? So that's an actual elected guy already. And now here I'm going to show you the head of the DNC. So here is, let's get past this. Here's Tom Perez.
But Jimmy, I want to say something about that guy's, sure. That guy's explanation of what the Democrat, and the equal opportunities, you know, if you work hard and don't make excuses, you could take that same empty verbiage and put it into a Republican speech against affirmative action or something like that, and it would work just as fine.
It would work just
I mean, those were empty, vacant words that can be used to justify bullshit.
And right now, the Democratic Party is empty and vacant, and all they have to offer people is bullshit. In fact, right now, they're fighting, kicking and screaming at the top of their lungs to hang on to a right-wing healthcare plan with no cost controls, which is basically a giveaway to big pharma and health insurance companies. That's what the Democrats are fighting for. And most of it, the goddamn Republicans agree to. So here is Tom Perez. Same question, same problem. This is the leader guy, handpicked by Barack Obama. You want to see how empty Barack Obama's Democratic Party is? What do you stand for?
Trump told CPAC on Friday that the Republican Party from now on will be the party of the American worker. And in November, President Trump carried white voters without a college degree, working class voters, by a staggering 37 percentage points. What is your plan to win these voters back into the Democratic fold?
We're gonna end the wars abroad and take that money and reinvest it right here, creating great jobs, building infrastructure, two, free college for everybody, free tuition for everybody who wants to get a leg up in America, number three, $15 minimum wage, number four, card check for unions. We're going to try to strengthen unions. And number five, we're going to give Medicare for all. That's our big thing, single payer. Everybody's a for it. 60% of the American people are already for it. We're going to start with a public option. That's 80% of people are for it. So these are our big ideas, and we're going to break up Wall Street, by the way, because they have too much power and everyone knows that has to happen. So that's our big new deal. Oh, we have a Green New Deal. We want to reinvest in renewable energy here at home. So those would be that's our big plan. Afford free college tuition for anybody who wants to go and can qualify. We're going to stop the wars, invest back at home. We're going to give you Medicare for all, $15 minimum wage, and strengthen unions through card check. Is that what you're going to say to those working people who abandoned the Democratic Party because the Democratic Party has nothing to offer them and they got in bed with the people who are working against working people, meaning Wall Street? Let's see what he says. What's Tom Perez's big? This is their big communicator. This is the guy who's been doing it his whole life.
We lead with our values and we lead with our actions. We talk to them about how literally hours into the Trump...
Nothing. We lead with our values and our actions. You know what your actions are? You voted to keep taking corporate money. That was your first action. That's it. You lead with our values and our actions. Your actions show that you're a sellout to corporations. Your values, you don't tell me what they are. And here's the first piece of action he shows us is that he's not Trump.
Administration. He was a fraud. He made it harder for first-time home buyers to buy a home.
So that's what the Democrats are about, Tom? That's the question. What's your message? And your message is Trump's bad. That's your message? Again, you tried this before. You tried the no message thing. We're not as bad as those guys before. And where are you, Tom? Completely wiped out. Barack Obama leaves the White House and the Democratic Party in ruins. Ruins, because you don't stand for shit. Nothing. That's why, Tom, you mealy-mouthed corporate tool. Get ready to lose in 2018, but nobody ever has to pay a price at the DNC. Donna Brazile, loser. Debbie Wasserman Schultz, unbelievable loser and cheater. You cheated the country out of a progressive. You cheated your own goddamn party. You didn't cheat the Republicans. You gave the Republicans the White House. You cheated the progressives. You cheated Democrats. You cheated America. And here's their new guy telling you to fall in line. Let's unite behind this. This is a joke. Tom Perez is a fucking joke. And you know it and I know it. And Tom Perez knows he's a joke too. And he knows he's going to lose. They're losers. This is a losing strategy. They just lost with this strategy. So let's listen to his whole stupid, vacuous, empty answer.
Hours into his administration, days later, he made it harder to save for retirement. He nominates a judge for the Supreme Court who wants to eviscerate collective bargaining. When we lead with our values as Democrats and talk about what we've done to...
What? What are your values? What the fuck are they, Tom?
We're friends. We're all friends. The Democrats. We're best. We have bracelets.
This is sickening. This is sad and disgusting. And a lot of times when people get into public life, they disconnect their shame mechanism. Tom Perez has done that. He's not embarrassed. He should have been humiliated by the way he answered the question at the DNC debate. He wasn't. He's still in public life. I would have fucking left life if that happened to me. He's still here, and here he is doing it again.
Make sure we're protecting Social Security, protecting Medicare, growing good jobs in this economy. If you
we want to be growing good jobs. That's a policy? Growing good jobs is a policy? We're going to protect Social Security and Medicare, even though you guys tried to cut it. Even though Barack Obama tried to cut it time and time again. But now you guys are for it. Really. In a very mealy-mouthed way, you're for it. You didn't say expand Social Security and Medicare. You said protect. Even when you're talking about Social Security and Medicare, which are super popular, you can't even get behind it.
Good jobs, elect a Democrat. That's the message that we have to communicate. It's a message that is true. It resonates in every...
There's no message, Tom! Tom, here's a little tip. That's not a message. Those are empty platitudes thought up in a corporate think tank, you fucking loser. You empty vessel. This is the guy hurting the country. These are the corporatists who are hurting the country. It's not an actress or an anti-fracking activist or a nightclub comedian or a YouTube jagoff. It's these guys with real power. and real money. This is called selling out America. And why does he sound like that? Because he's bought! Of course! We're going to try it one more time. Let's beat Trump with corporate money one more time.
Zip code, and that's what we're going to be doing all over this nation, leading with our values, leading with the facts. And the facts are Democrats grow the middle class, Democrats protect economic security, and we need to do a better job of communicating that message everywhere.
So we got to, we got our value, we got to lead with our, we got to communicate better. Dude, you have to have something to communicate. You guys keep acting like we're just not saying the right buzzwords.
We got to communicate better, said the guy who can't answer a direct question.
We got to communicate better. I can't answer your question. I can't tell you what we're for. But we need to communicate that we don't know what we're for better. You're a joke, Tom Perez. You are a joke, a corporate stooge. This is what you look like. You're laughable. You're a joke.
You're probably reluctant to criticize Hillary Clinton, but are you of the opinion that her campaign did not talk about those economic values sufficiently, instead focusing on the perceived character flaws of the current president?
Jake Tapper, that's his real name, not his porn name, just laid out the exact case that I'm laying out. Exactly. He got it. Jake, you got it. Jake's doing it. By the way, Jake's a little better than all the rest of the news guys. I'm going to just say that. I'll just say it. Anyway, I'm not saying he's fantastic. I'm saying that's how low the bar is. But that's a great... There, he just nailed it, though. He just did it. Hey, this sounds exactly like what Hillary Clinton tried, and you guys lost with this. So let's see what he says.
Well, certainly we have to do a better job as a Democratic Party of messaging what we stand for. We have to make sure that we're out there...
Watch him. Watch him make sure. We're never going to tell you what he stands for. Never. Never.
Everywhere talking about how we're the party of good job creation, we're the party of middle class security, we're the party of inclusion. We believe our diversity is...
We're the party of good jobs and more money for everyone. We're the party for more good things. We're the party for you to feel better when you wake up. We're the party for morning sunrises and nice sunsets. We're the party of morning dew. We're that party. We're the party of puppies and cookies and ice cream. That's what we're the party of. Oh, and good jobs. And how are we going to get them? We're going to get them by having good jobs. That's what we're going to do. We're going to have good jobs. How? By being more good jobs.
We're going to grow them.
We're going to grow good jobs. By messaging our message.
You know, Jimmy, just when I thought I couldn't believe in the Democratic Party, now I'm like, I'm so inspired these empty words. I'm like, yes, Democrats.
Well, I hope that guy's speaking at a stadium somewhere. I'll go not listen.
Greatest strength. And when we lead with these values, I believe we succeed.
Yeah, when we lead with our values, we succeed. Oh, I have no idea what you're talking about. And guess what, Tom? You don't have any idea what you're talking about either. You know why, Tom? Because you're not talking about anything. You're talking about keeping the status quo. Money people's running the government and running our lives and keeping half the country poor. That's what you're talking about, Tom Perez. And that's why people are defecting from the Democratic Party and why you're a loser. Hey, our next show is March 20th in Burbank. It's almost sold out. Our next show after that is April 3rd in Hollywood at the Improv. Links for tickets right below.